Welcome to Jung Tuition. Are you looking for new ideas and in-depth analysis on climate change and global warming? Then this is a unique channel for you. In my previous video, I discussed several experiments that were supposed to demonstrate the greenhouse effect due to carbon dioxide gas in the confined space. Unfortunately, all of them have failed in providing a direct evidence. Today, I'd like to ask you just one basic question. What are the differences between a greenhouse that you could easily build in your backyard and the real atmosphere around the Earth? As you know, an ordinary greenhouse is made by glass or plastic. Ideally, such material should be transparent to solar shortwave radiation, but opaque to the infrared radiation re-emitted by the heated ground. In essence, a greenhouse is always kept sealed unless the air temperature inside becomes too high. In this way, no heat inside a greenhouse can escape by means of convection, as shown by this computer simulation. Of course, the internal convection is still going on towards a mean internal temperature all the time. As a result, the air temperature inside could be kept warm for a long period of time, which could be noticeably higher than air temperature outside. In terms of heat transfer, the relatively cold air is constantly heated up by the ground, as well as other condensed materials through direct thermal conduction and facilitated by the internal air convection. Because some air molecule can absorb infrared radiation, such as water vapor and CO2, direct heat transfer from those infrared radiation sources to the air could occur, making the internal transfer faster. It is expected that the air warm-up period in the presence of concentrated CO2 should be noticeably shorter compared with dry air. But as I will explain soon, this has nothing to do with the global warming. That's all for a greenhouse. Now, let's have a close look of our atmosphere. First of all, the atmosphere is extremely thin compared with the radius of the Earth. So, it seems unlikely the atmosphere could play a predominant role in determining the surface temperature at which the infrared radiation occurs, according to Stefan Boltzmann's law. This is similar to how the air is unable to affect the ground temperature inside a real greenhouse, because the air is passively heated up by the warmer condensed materials. More importantly, unlike any greenhouse, our atmosphere is completely open to the outer space, which is much colder than the Earth's surface. In principle, therefore, any surplus in the accumulated internal energy by the air could spontaneously escape from the Earth by means of radiation. That is why our atmosphere knows how to regulate its temperature and pressure without any help from humans, just as how your local weather changes all the times. You could call our atmosphere as a blanket, but bear in mind, it is far from complete opaque to infrared ray. In terms of least action principle in physics, it is necessary for the atmosphere as a whole absorb about 40% of the terrestrial infrared radiation, which is sufficient to keep our atmosphere warm enough to reach the thermal equilibrium with the surface, as admitted by Dr. Manabi.
Thus, atmosphere as a whole reduced by about 40% the upward flux of long-wave radiation emitted by the Earth's surface, helping to maintain warm and habitable planet at the Earth's surface, which we enjoy now.
Notice the boundary condition TA equal to TS is satisfied at the surface, both in the atmosphere and inside a greenhouse, where TA is the air temperature and TS is the surface temperature. So in this regard, the atmosphere and a greenhouse are identical. But how about the greenhouse effect? Well, in history, the greenhouse effect was merely introduced to artificially offset the theoretical discrepancy in the calculated surface temperature, which is 32 Kelvin to be exact, arising from using an incorrect model called the black body. In short, the greenhouse effect has nothing to do with a real greenhouse. Confused? No worry, I will explain this next time. So stay tuned. Thank you for watching. See you next time.